Today I'm here with a new video, and today I'm here with the palette of the month for April. And as I said in the last part for March, it was going to be a palette that is pretty new but that I want to play more with, and it starts with an A, and it is of course Arcana from Shroud. I love this palette. I can leave my first impression up here. The palette looks like this. If you didn't know, it's like, I just love it. It's grungy, it's just amazing, and the shimmers are amazing, and the mattes are amazing. So yeah, I'm going to play with this today, and today I am going to do whatever I want, and I think I already know what I want to do, but I'm not completely sure if I'm going to be completely honest. I've swatched a little bit, but it's like, it feels like I want to swatch some more. So I will start with Sacred in my crease, and I hope it works in my crease. I think it's a little bit darker, and yeah, what is this? And I feel that a lot with this palette, that the shades are darker swatched and on the eye than the look in the pan. And I know that some people don't like it. I don't mind that much. I rather have it that way, that it looks, that it is darker than it looks, than the other way around. It's maybe just a preference. I like more dark shadows mostly, so yeah. And I'm just smashing this in my crease, and I maybe should have taken away my eyebrows before I started. I like never know if I like to have them on or not, but I don't think I do, but yeah. And it is pretty much kick up in this palette. If you have used any palettes from Shroud, I feel that all of the palettes has a lot of kick up. I don't mind. But if you're like a neat freak and want to keep your palettes clean, maybe that's not the best. But I don't really care. And then I want to go in with this Darkling. It's green, but it's really, really dark, and I want to take it on my outer half of my lid. And I think it's more like green and gray. I don't know. Maybe like military green? Dark military green? I don't know, but I like it, and I like that it's a little bit, that it is like that. That it's not like super green or just like a really dark. Okay, I don't know what I'm trying to say. I like this shade. I think I want to go in with my crease brush, just with no additional products, and just blend it a little bit in the crease. Maybe I want a little bit more of this dark shade out here, out and up. And then to top it off with a shimmer, I really want to take this Enchantress, this pink one, I almost said purple, the pink one, and put it in here. And this, like, when I swatched it, do you see? It is just amazing, and it sticks so good without any glitter glue, and I think it lays over other shades so good, and it's easy to blend out in the crease a little bit. And I really, really love shimmer shades that are like that. So you don't like just blend them away. I like them to be a little bit blendable. And then I just go in with the dark green a little bit to make the edge a little bit better. Like that, and like that. I really like this. I think at least, maybe the pink shimmer took over a little bit, but I just love the shade. So I am going to take away the fallouts, fix my base, and then I come back and we do something to the under eyes. And I think I will keep it as this, maybe put something in my inner corner, I don't know, but I will put on my base and then I come back. So okay, it's time for the under eyes, and I think I will take the exact same shade. So I will start with this one that I had in my crease and like spoke it out, going deepen down the outer corner with this, and then I think I will take this Enchantress to like connect. And sorry for all the sounds, but it's so warm in this apartment. So I open the window and it's cars driving outside. So I will start with Sacred. I hope it's pronounced like that. And then I go in with the dark green, Darkling, and just put it out here. And this is mainly like to connect. I don't want so much dark under my eye, but I still want it to look a little bit better. And then I take Enchantress, and I think I will try without spraying it, just to see how it will look, and I hope it will not fall. I don't think it will. And this totally work without spraying it, so that's good. Okay, so I think I like this super dark look that it turned out to be. I will put on mascara, something in my waterline, and try to choose a lip, and it feels like I want to go with a dark lip as well. I don't know yet, we will see. So I will fix the last things and then I come back. So this is the finished look for my waterline. I used Insomniac from ColourPop, and on my lips I used the Sophia Nygaard and ColourPop collab in Bury Me in a Lipstick, and I like this look. I love the shimmers in this palette. They are just amazing, and I don't want to do like three looks with this palette where I use a shimmer and a matte, but I think it will end up like that because I just love the shimmers in this one. So for this look I have used this one, Sacred, it must be Sacred, Enchantress, and Darkling. And I really, really like this look. So yeah. This is, and now I have something here on my face. I think this is going to be the newest palette that I use for a palette of the month. But it's just like, I want to use this so much more because I just love this. And I think next time I may will do a palette bingo with this. We will see. So yeah, I really hope you like this video, and if you're not subscribed to my channel, please do so you don't miss any of my videos, and I hope I will see you in the next one. Bye!